Tiggyworld. The server with the worst frame rate and an even worse host. That's a great intro, don't you say? So anyways, ignore that block and oh my god, the frame rate is very bad this episode, I apologize. But today, we are going to be making a roller coaster. Now, we probably will not be able to finish it this episode, but we'll get part of it done, I guess. So, first of all, let's start off with this station. We're going to have to pick a location. I think this is fine. Then again, we're not really going for realism on this theme park's placing. We're just kind of going for realism on the rides itself. So, you're going to start off with a station. Now, the larger the station, the more detailing you can do and stuff. So, I like to make kind of like a medium station, just because it does take up a lot of space if they're way too big. Now, the problem with Minecraft building is that one block equals 1 meter, which is great. You can make rides, like, to scale. But the only problem with that is Minecraft scaling is weird. So what looks like really tall and goes into the clouds in real life might actually not be that tall. So I'm basing this roller coaster off of Fury 325 at Carowinds, which is over 300 feet tall. In fact, it's 325 feet tall. If I make it 325 blocks, but you need to figure out that in meters, which is probably very high, and that's a lot of blocks. But it looks absurdly tall if you actually do the correct amount of blocks. So you really just have to kind of eyeball it to see what looks tall and what looks good. It's very hard making builds in Minecraft to scale. And I find that really the only way to make builds to scale are very small buildings. Like you can't make a skyscraper to scale unless you're a madman. Then you could, but it would look not very good. So yeah. Anyways, back to the roller coaster. So I'm basing this off of Fury 325, and you might be seeing that I am making kind of like a staircase thing. Now, I'm not going to place down the rails yet, but we're going to just staircase thing. So that looks tall enough. Maybe we'll... So now what we're going to do is we're going to kind of make it flatten out very slowly. And then we'll make this area kind of like a kind of top part. Make it go up one in this and then we'll just... You actually should probably leave one block extra there just so it looks smoother. And yeah, I think that's a good elevation. Now we're going to start off by maybe going down just the tiniest bit. And then we're going to start going real down. So now if you look at the images of Fury 325, it drops down very, very, very steep. Now, what we may have to do is do this. Now, you might say, what are you doing? What are you doing? Now, what I'm doing is I'm making it drop a bit. Since it's Minecraft and you can't really make things steep, you have to sometimes make things drop a bit, which seems kind of like very, very stupid, but it works if you make them drop a bit. So you're just gonna have to make it kind of drop a bit because this looks now very steep. Well, as like before, it did would not, since there are very few roller coasters that have the same degree going up as they do down. I can think of one in Japan, but it's credited for being a very weird roller coaster. So just stick with this being steeper. Now, if you really want to have no drops, you can make this like go up every two blocks, but that just takes up so much space. Now, honestly, I just find it easier to do it this way. Now, if you look at an image of Fury 325, which I am right now in my real life studio, I know I actually exist in real life. Wow. I'm looking at an image right now and you can see that it will go down and then it will just kind of flatten out a bit and then it'll do a big overbank turn over that way. Now, what we are going to do before we do that is we are going to, and we'll probably end up doing that next episode or the episode after. But now we're going to have to get supports. Now, supports are... There's a trick to supports. Now, just making one line is ugly. It's bad. What you need to do is you need to kind of make it stick out a bit and go like this. Now, if you see, that looks... And then you make it on two different sides. And now you see that looks way more realistic than just like a straight line, which we do not want. So, boom. Look at that. That looks pretty good. Now, that's what we're going to do the whole way up. So, I will do that. And just to save your, like, time, I know this is a tutorial, but you've already kind of seen how to do it. I am going to be placing all of these supports. Now, I'm probably going to do them, like, four blocks around, like every five blocks there's a support. You can really just customize it on the depending on the size of your roller coaster. But yeah, see you then. Yeah, these supports are done. So as you can see, they look very nice. This is a very nice support design. Looks a lot nicer than if you just made a bunch of like white concrete sticks. Which is why I like this. Now what next we're going to do is we're going to add the rails. Now this is the hard part. All you're going to need is a powered rail and a normal rail and a redstone torch. Now, I might be wrong about the redstone torch, but let's just... Yeah, so I was. Never mind. All you're going to need is a redstone block. Might be ugly, but it's your only option. So you're gonna start off with a redstone block will power a lot of these rails. So you're going to try to just kind of put in between every while just a normal rail. It kind of just makes everything a lot more realistic. It's just like, rails are pretty fun to pull off. You don't really need to do too much on the rail front. I broke a block. Woo. You can just kind of fool around with them and they'll end up looking good. So I wouldn't stress too much if your rails are a bit too fast or a bit too slow. It's all fun. Anyways, so yeah, don't stress it. So yeah, so what I like to do is just every block that you cannot... that the power rail dies, just put a normal rail and then more powered rails. And once you get to the top, just to kind of change it from falling over, just place some normal rails. Now in this spot, you're gonna definitely need normal rails. So it's gonna fall onto these, which it's gonna be fine. Now make sure that it did not go sideways like what just happened there, because that will be a major problem for when you ride it. So yeah, now we are going to need a minecart, and let's just test out the ride. It's gonna be fun. Well, I hope it's gonna be fun. I don't know, I haven't rode in it yet. So we're gonna get in and then go up the massive hill, then right to the top, and then look, you should. Now that will sometimes happen, which is very much annoying, but let's just try it again. You know, it's all about trial and error. Hopefully we can figure out the problem with this ride. So, try attempt two. It's once again has stopped, which is a problem, but nothing that... Which is a problem, but I think I know what the problem is. It's not going, which is very much a problem. So what if... So I think that you can put powered rails on this and it'll work. You know, it's just all about trial and error. Don't be afraid to try new things when you're making a roller coaster. Just have some fun with it. This is all about fun. If you get stressed out while making your roller coaster, stop making your roller coaster. Don't get stressed out when making a something in Minecraft. It's just a blocky game. It's just a blocky game. That's what we all say to ourselves. A lot of things have happened to me because of Minecraft. So yeah, more than just a blocky game, but for the sake of this argument, it's just a blocky game. So let's just try this once more. You go up the ride, and then... works flawlessly. So yeah, that will be the end of the competition. If you came here from my appearance in the MV Perry Discord build competition, hello, you probably did not. Yeah, goodbye.